Hello, landing tubers, and welcome back to Let's Land a UFO in XCOM Long War? That's the one. With me, BlueAnkylo. So, we've got a medium-large landed raider. Not large, just a medium landed raider UFO. It's a bit scary, but it shouldn't be as bad as the largest we've dealt with. Somewhat successfully, to a point. Now, the good news is we've got some beam optics, some armor piercing. What do we call this thing? I always forget. Armor piercing. Not armor penetrating. And we've got quite a few sergeants. You know, it'd be nice to have tech sergeants by now or gunnery sergeants, but you know, you get what you get. Nothing really new on the loadout. This is pretty normal stuff, I think. Hopefully you guys recognize your name if you're along, and let's get to it. Touching down. So, United States, hey? So I've seen landed mediums go real easy with like 12 to 15 to real bad with like 30 to 40. Basically the same as a large landed in vanilla. We'll see what happens. We've also heard that in XCOM, the aliens can actually do what's called a... Oh, I forget. What is it called? It's exactly this thing I was about to say, and then I forgot the word. For all of you Counter-Strike players or people that understand, like they can do like an economy round where for 1 month they save their resources and don't send very many missions at you, and then the month after that they will do a buy round where they go crazy and try to overwhelm you. From what I understand, they can do that whenever they want. So that's something to keep in mind. If you're ever playing along and it seems like you're having a really good month, it might just be that the aliens are taking it easy on you, and they're about to get evil next month. So I do want to take this one more carefully than usual. Basically.
Moving out.
Also, let's continue to fix up people with pyrokinesis when we notice. Heading to that location. Okay, well, it doesn't look like we're going to run into anything on the first turn. As long as I'm at least a little careful. Headed there now. It's like one square further to the left. Just the kind of thing that gets me killed, usually.
Right there. Got my eyes on.
I didn't bring... How did that happen? Oh, you know what that is? I don't know if I've mentioned this on camera before. The command interface for the officers is a little bit buggy. He should have two of each. It'll update eventually. I'm pretty sure. Because, yeah, Grenadier should be two of either AP or HE. We've done that 1,000 times. On my way. Aye, aye, Commander. Just want to make sure my sniper's in somewhere with vision. There we go. See, now they're back up to date. Confused me for a second as well. So, if you guys have been noting the item counts are a little wonky every now and then, that was just... It's probably already been patched, I betcha. It's already... I'm playing on 15E, but I haven't updated it within a couple weeks, so I wouldn't be surprised if that's been fixed already. I don't really like updating a whole lot in the middle of a campaign. Although, we've already done it once.
Moving.
You may also know that the super loud Australian voice actor has been toned down. That was patched as well from 15C to 15E. Looks like this is a pretty large map, which tends to help not force you to run into every alien on the same time, on the same turn. Generally. Which makes things a little bit less deadly. Changed my mind, we're all coming back. What? How did we see that? It's just drones, but... Better just be drones. Who triggered that? Was it the scout running backwards? This is why if I had snapshot, it would be so much better. I could just kill them all right now. This is why I hate grenades. I can't make the grenade go up, so I can't even deal with them. Like, that's supposed to be what heat warheads on grenades are supposed to be for. It's for dealing with packs of drones. Except that you can't get any vertical throw. There's no way to make it explode in the air. Unless you're just lucky and it hits a tree or something along the way, but... You can't shoot. You've already moved. You're too far away. So... Looks like we're taking a bunch of normal, boring shots here. Well, I do have one option, for instance. I could move my engineer closer and try to throw a grenade from, like, here. Because I could command him with the infantry. But I think we're better off just like one shot. Not happy about this lack of... Rocket. A rocket would do it, right? If I just had snapshot, I'd be fine. You know what? We're gonna try. Okay. We only get one command per mission at Lieutenant. Let's see if it works. Really hoping I'd be able to get a bounce here that did what I wanted it to do. Because I'm nice and close, there's some stuff around. I don't think we can make it. I guess we get the one kill, but I don't think it's going to do us any real favors here. 3D grenade area of effect is really difficult to deal with. I mean, you can even select them, but it just doesn't bounce up high enough to hit them. You'd think there'd be a way to do what I'm trying to do, but... I hope I clicked where I wanted to click. We'll see. Nah, it did. I mean, it killed one, sure, but... It's not as good as I was hoping. Well, we killed one. We might be able to kill another one if we're lucky. Maybe I should just smoke all these people in half cover. That'd be the most beneficial. Because he's likely to be flanked now, and then these guys are in half. So he has to shoot at someone in full cover, or at least in smoke. And I don't think you have a chance of a kill... So you can steady. I don't think a laser carbine can kill these in one hit. I think the smoke was a good idea. I know they're just drones, but like... Only took one hit out of three, so I'd say that was a success. Alright, so, gunner. You only see two. And you miss anyway. So much for that anti-armor. Sniper! They're technically too close, I bet. Actually, no. This one tree is blocking, like, all of our shots, too, on the third one. Ugh. Gross. Lack of death. What? How can this not see anything? Just it's because that's full cover. I should have moved. Sometimes the game is trying to get you to uninstall it. Like that. Missing lots of shots today. A real bundle of fun. Should have moved my shotgun right here, basically. Would have been probably, well, possibly a kill. Hopefully a kill. Kill it. I was saving that rocket just in case I needed it, but we're just gonna soak one more drone hit, I guess. You know, close combat could trigger any time. I think if I'd moved my assault properly, we would have been able to kill it with, we would have been able to kill both of them via close encounters. It's just stupid drones. Well, I guess we need to do some healing, huh? Sure would be nice if we had the advanced medkit, would have healed him up to full. But we've got enough medkits for now. But yeah, 3 HP per heal is pretty pathetic. Good to go. Ready to rock. Ready to rock and to roll.
I'm ready. Okay.
I blame most of that on the lack of a grenade being useful. If grenades just did what they were supposed to do, I would have been fine. I also blame it on the activation being kind of dumb. I can blame everyone except myself. It's what you get to be. If you're a YouTuber, you can do that too.
On it.
UFO is somewhere over there. That's actually the edge of the map. We've gone too far left now. I'll tell you what, you can dash up to there.
I'm on it, Commander. We're green to go.
Get back in the fight, soldier. No, that was... How did that happen? That, again... It's not where I clicked. Alright. I'm gonna have to take a break after this episode, I think. We're at the point where I'm starting to make misclicks and silly errors. It's time to break up the long war. This has been a longer session than I normally record for, though. Because it's been going so well. Usually I can only handle, like, 2 or 3 episodes in a row these days because I just get so mad, start making dumb mistakes. Or, like, depressed because we've, lost half our squad. Alright, so here's the first Berserker, I believe. Good fun for all. Ridiculously hard to hit for no good reason. So the sniper will actually not have a good shot there. I'd rather try to kill the Overwatch on this side. Okay, that's good. Now, the next step requires bundles of fun. Bundles of fun engage. That's less fun. But I had to do something like this. Sure, it activated some sectoids. Don't worry, Drake. You'll probably be fine. A crit and a shred. And then it should be one more shot. I mean, it was only 10 damage, but 10 damage for one action, basically. So then I want... Sure would be nice if my infantry was in a better spot, huh? That'd be great. Now, this guy almost certainly has shock-absorbing armor, which is why he took so little damage. Can't move and shoot. None of the sectoids are going to get vision on this guy. Just the floater is possible. We can kill the floater. That's disappointing. Adjusting sights. As much as those sectoids are going to be a hassle, this thing has to die. Yeah, we could try to mind fray it. You know, even though you're out in the open here, that might be your best option. Because someone has to kill this thing. And I want to make sure I have that second shot for emergencies. Maybe. Let's try the medic. You don't have vision. Of course you don't have vision. Why would you have vision? Alright. Stay out of the close shock-absorbing armor range. Just get lucky. Come on. Come on, Hans. Ah, so many misses this turn.
I'll get him next time.
This is probably within shock armor range. Come on, get lucky. Not even close. How do you do 3 damage on something that's shredded? I really wanted to use the scout to kill, or to try to kill that floater at least. Doing it, leaving you out in the open. It's everyone's favorite strategy. Just remember, it's not all that exposed because it's behind a hill. And we killed the floater that I was worried about. Okay. Could hunker or I could pull back. Let's pull back. Make them come to us. I'm kind of annoyed that we activated that sectoid squad because I wanted to get close to the berserker, but there was probably a way of ordering the operation such that I didn't have to move that close, but we also missed like 3, 60, 70, 80% shots somewhere in that range. So you couldn't have trusted a whole lot of plans to work out in that situation because they would have all missed. This guy's mind is sturdy. He's just made of good stuff. Of course, this guy's mind is made of bubblegum. So who was that? King Cobra, apparently your brain is mush. But Eddie Magnuson, your brain is very good. Very sturdy. I got one shot there. Tempted to try that from up close. There we got vision on everything. Destroy as much cover as you can. Kill if you can, of course. That's a pretty good grenade. It actually didn't expose the one I wanted it to expose. shoot the one in the back, it might chain kill one of the guy in the front. If we could have hit it. I guess we take the squad side shot. It's not good. It does apply hollow. Would have been nice to use our squad sight to get that shot too, actually. If we had Psy Inspiration, we could break it. We could fix our shot, but it's not going to happen. We're too early on in the game. Try again to destroy some cover. Rockets have been pretty good in this in the past. Ooh, didn't go where I wanted it to go, but it did kill too. Alright, we're not going to complain about that one. Who would complain about that? I should have moved. I should have done it like this. I should have moved you out of the way and had you just reload back there. And then I should have moved the infantry into full cover.
Moving to position. Oh yeah. Moving out.
Well, we're probably fine one way or the other. It's just one sectoid left, I think. And he's a chicken. A little chicken sectoid. Okay, well, mine meld will, or mine fray won't last forever.
Heading to that location. We're green to go.
In fact, at this point, you can move up and just hunker down. It'll be fine. Of course, that gets rid of my own cover, but I wonder if that thing will come back.
I'm on the move. Ready to rock.
Got it covered.
You can make sure the sniper has a shot when we move forward. Similarly, the gunner, if possible. I think we're in a good spot. Now we can move forward. Mindfray is gone. So we move up and have a look. Not much of a look thanks to the slope. Yeah, there's too much stuff blocking line of sight here. But everyone up on front will probably just hunker. And then we'll have at least the sniper on protection detail. I'll keep the infantry on overwatch.
Robert, got my eyes on.
Do I need any rockets here? Not right now. Not against one sectoid. Next turn, we'll get the meld if it's still there.
Moving out. What's making that noise?
Saw the sectoid go that way. That could be another pod or the outsiders. Possibly the sectoid circled round. It's also possible that the berserker we fought had more aliens in its pod that we just haven't seen yet.
Goods.
Yeah.
Aye, aye, Commander.
That's why I keep saying we're not actually doing that well. I think the alien research is just miles ahead of ours.
Aye, aye.
Interesting.
That's affirmative.
Well, we've made it pretty far, getting close, so... I like the sniper up there. Let's move the rest of the team a bit closer to the action. Got lots of full cover right now.
Got it covered.
I like this spot for the sniper. Nice high ground. So, now... we prepare a door breach, I guess? I should have a look around that corner first, maybe. Just in case. Still pretty happy being up here on this hill for a little bit longer until we get inside the UFO. I think the gunner can cover this side on his own. Well, basically on his own.
I'm on it.
I know we've got at least one alien activated. There is a mod that I've been recommended that will tell you how many things you've activated that are not dead, basically. It doesn't tell you how many aliens are on the map, but sort of right around here, it shows, you know, I've activated a sectoid and three floaters, but they're not dead yet.
Getting it done. You hear that?
I don't know where the rest of the deadly baddies are, but...
okay, here they come.
Okay, well, there's some of them. It's a disappointing activation. Those doors being open sucks. Can't get a rocket anywhere in there at all. Safest thing here is probably just to get back outside.
Moving out.
Can still see them from there, oddly enough. These things don't do anything but shoot at you, so there's no reason to make this easy on them.
Moving out.
Go. They may get the first shot, but it's not going to be a good shot.
Rolling out.
I still think my sniper might get a shot from here. Get you close enough so you can use a grenade next turn. It's hopefully just a sectoid. What I would prefer is if these guys move forward into like half cover or something. Still full cover.
I'm all right.
Now we should be pretty safe between full cover and smoke. So there's no guarantee, but... okay, we did find the sectoids. We're not going to get a flank here.
Aye, aye.
Might draw the Overwatch, though. Now, if I get hit again... the last time I used lightning reflexes, we got hit. Even with that 90% garbage. I don't know if I could reliably destroy any of their cover. I'm gonna try though. Don't think we're gonna get that one at all, but if I could at least make one of these easy to get to. And it's possible. I don't know. Let's give it a try. I don't think these walls are going to break easily, but... I don't think I did anything. That's how it always works for me. Then we could shred them both. That will help. That's different. That's probably a bug. I don't know what we activated through a wall that shouldn't have been hit, but that's probably a bug. Looks like we destroyed some of the cover on this door, but nothing else really. Well, this guy's been shredded if we can hit him. Closer to the other one at that.
That is not good.
Ooh, there's a hit. Well, I'm a little bit concerned about what we activated, but oh, the door is there, of course. Well, should be fine. I guess it's worth a shot. One down. Sniper, unfortunately, not terribly useful thus far. So, dash him up. A little bit worried about my assault over there. I think we'll still take this shot again. Two misses at 41, that's too bad, but he was shredded, so if we could have hit him, it probably would have been enough. So glad I moved my my sniper up. Now he's useless. Maybe an opportunist overwatch would have been better there. So much for full cover. Also, oh wait, no, we only had a normal... This is not a captain. I was thinking we should have absorbed two if we'd had a captain officer, but we did not.
Moving to position. He's down.
And it did count for close encounters. Woohoo!
I'm rolling.
Let's open with Hollow this time rather than messing around like we did last. We don't have a very good chance, so we have to milk it for every little extra we can. 51's better than 41. Come on. He should still be shredded. We just can't seem to hit it. Oh, I should also do some heals here. The last heal, that's a little bit scary. If anyone gets critically injured. I don't have the option now.
I'm on it, Commander.
Come on, hit this thing. We're having a really hard time with the outsider. Why is it so hard to hit? Just high cover sucks. I guess I can't get a grenade in there like I wanted. That sucks too! Mind Fray is gonna really mess with any shots our sniper could have. Actually, I think it's more likely we're gonna get a shot on that side, yeah. Come on, don't hit anybody. Tired of you hitting us through full cover, but us being impossible to hit you from full cover. Come on, 36%. You never know, right?
Moving to
Oh, you know. Actually, never mind. We did just fine. You did just fine there, buddy. Of course, it's managed to outline of sight anyone who could see it, but otherwise, it is flanked. Just not from this angle. Oh, that's hilarious. So I basically get one person who can take advantage of that. Two if I rush up. Please kill it. Okay, I think our engineer can finish this guy. Yeah, this will be a flank for sure. Okay, good. So now the next question, and this is a good question, is what did we activate with the Shredder rocket? And maybe more importantly, where is it? Let's take a turn to get everyone reloaded and whatnot. I mean, I think we're pretty good, but I know we activated another pod, and I don't really have much idea what they are. Which is a little bit scary to move into an activated room. It was a muton. That's just not enough. I mean, that was good. I'm glad you guys teamworked it. But if there's another one coming, you're gonna wish you one-shot it, huh? Actually, never mind, you're fine. Apparently these guys are dumb. Apparently I can't hit an 81% shot for the life of me. Alright then, shotgun it is. So if it was an entire pod of mutons, that's a little scary. Medic. Might as well keep them safe if I can. Don't really want to hide over there just yet. I'm a little bit short on the left side right now, so we'll move the scout over there. Might as well keep it 4-4. Come on. Yeah. Infantry opportunist. Hey, the sectoid that ran away. We found it. It might be the last thing here. Could be possible. Glad that worked. If that's the last alien, though, we're pretty much safe.
Heading there now.
Moving to Overwatch.
Of course, there's no guarantee that's the last alien. Have a little peek around the corner. Well, if there's nothing there, I think you're okay to go have a look out here, Drake. Two shots at 100%, right? That was it? Oh, it wasn't so bad. Landed Raider. Still took 40 minutes, but, we still got one nasty injury, but otherwise it was pretty good. Another promotion. We've got our first Berserker. Pretty good amount of Illyrium. Actually, really good meld and decent Illyrium and alloys. Yeah, it wasn't so bad. Not too shabby, guys. Alright, well, we're probably going to wrap things up pretty quick. I always like to end with what the next episode, what the next mission will be as a bit of a, that sucks. As a bit of a, you know, teaser. That's really bad. What's going on in Nigeria, guys? Nigeria's done. That's number 4. Looks like we're not saving South Africa. Or just Africa as a whole. The sculpts are good, and I did say once I had that finished, I wanted to remember to queue up. Yeah, we don't have enough of those, but we want to get this going right away. That will give our scopes plus 8 crit, which is pretty awesome, pretty awesome. I haven't had any more sats shot down, right? I only lost one, and the other one, the other satellite destroyer we shot down. Titan plating. So we will need more berserk corpses. So at this point, I guess we get the thin man out of the way, but we're probably going to go for advanced aerospace because it gives us all the foundry projects that upgrade our ravens. Mechs, we're not going to be able to afford them. Armor, I don't actually think the next tier of armor is a whole lot better than the flanks. We have to do 2 more tiers of armor to get Aegis, which is the stuff I like. Goss, I really couldn't afford to build anyway. Illyrium leads to all kinds of stuff, including pulse lasers. But let's stick with the quick stuff for now, I guess. I can't even risk shooting it, really. It lands, or it shoot. Well, this shouldn't be shooting any UFO down. It'll just, it's gonna do whatever its mission is, and there's nothing I can say about it. And it's a good thing, because we still only have a small chance of shooting this down. I don't know, small. We have a chance. The fact that they've sent 3 satellite seekers at me in a single month is pretty brutal. Approaching target now. Come on, these need a lot of luck for this one. Well, I'm glad we shot it down, but now we're out of interceptors. Well, that'll be the mission for next time. Next time it'll be that plus a covert op, certainly. This is not good. Not good at all. I seem to be getting more aircraft in North America than South America, but there's not much we can do right now. The air game, as always, frustrating. Anyway, let's wrap up the episode here, and I'll wrap up my session. Surprisingly positive session. Maybe I'm playing better because I haven't been live streaming. I don't know. Maybe I'm playing better because it's the middle of the night, and it's nice and cool out here instead of heat-waved hot. Anyway, thanks for watching, folks. Hope you've enjoyed, and have a great day.